I'm coordinating most of the science activities right now on our core science team. So we have a number of activities going on in the year before launch. Some of them involve mission-specific things like figuring out how the wave spectrum on the surface of the ocean affects our measurements. So I'm coordinating a sub-team of researchers who is actively investigating that. And then there's also a couple of other teams that are working on the implications of CYGNSS's measurements. CYGNSS is designed to fly between 35 degrees north and south latitudes, so we're targeting the tropics, and that was done specifically so that we can observe tropical cyclones and hurricanes. But we'll orbit far enough north and south to be able to start to capture some of the winter-type storms that form in the fall through winter through spring seasons in both the northern and southern hemispheres. So there's several unanswered questions about how wind speeds interact with waves and surface fluxes from the ocean, and how those surface fluxes feed back on the formation and evolution of winter-type storm systems. So I've got my student looking into that. For the most part, I think in the vast majority of cases, we can predict track very accurately. We still have a very hard time knowing how intense the storms will be when they get where they're going. And the intensity of hurricanes is really what causes all of the damage. So it's in particular the wind speed and then the way in which the winds drive water onto the coast. So the storm surge as well as the intensity of the winds. That determines how much damage there will be, and it determines whether or not you're going to need to evacuate the population or whether they can shelter in place. So when you're talking about impact of hurricanes, the intensity is really pretty much 90% of the story. This sort of framework where we send up multiple satellites that can observe the same spot in rapid succession is, I think, something that we're going to need to do a lot in the future. And so it's exciting to be part of a mission that's doing this for the first time. Right about the end of 2016 calendar year, we'll be on orbit and in our constellation. Now, that's actually going to be after the 2016 hurricane season. And what benefits about us about that is that we will then have a period of 6 months to make sure that all of our measurements are performing exactly as we expect them to before the 2017 hurricane season comes along.